Hi everyone, my name is Rodney Smith. I'm here with Board Game Geek at SPIEL 2018. I've been joined with David Liu of Mo Ideas Games. You brought East Indiaman.
Yes.
Tell me about this.
Okay, so this is a worker placement game that has a nice twist because the workers are your ships, and they're also your resources.
Ship workers, okay. Yes. And our resources.
Yes, and also your resources.
Okay, explain this to me.
So this is the worker placement game. In this game, on your turn, you get two actions.
Right.
An option of five actions listed here. The first thing you can do is to get resources, okay? So you find an empty spot on the map. You place one ship here to show that you want to get a yellow resource. We have four different resources, the red, yellow, green, and blue.
Okay, right.
When you get a red, yellow resource, you place it there. You also have to take an empty ship and place it here. Okay, so these ships, they don't have any cargo. So they are your workers, available workers.
Yes.
But when you place it up here, that means you have filled up with this kind of goods.
Okay.
Okay, that's one action.
Right.
When you get resources, you have to have some empty ships down here to hold the resource.
Right, okay. Makes sense. Okay.
So the next thing you could do, maybe I want this objective card. So the objective card costs two yellows, one red, one green, and I have
sure
this right
enough,
now.
Yeah. And that's what you're saying, it's on your resource as
yes.
well, right?
Okay. So now when I pay for this, I just move them down here and take the card. And now the ships come back to me as available workers.
Right, okay.
So the next time around, I'll actually have more ships.
So you really kind of need to be fulfilling these so you can get your ships back to go send them out again.
Is
that the idea? Okay.
Okay. So the next thing you can do is to build a trading post. Okay.
Right.
So this is a worker placement game. When you come later in this area, you have to pay more. So if the blue ones go here,
okay.
you have to pay two.
Right.
So next up, then I'll have to pay three.
Three. Right.
But if I have a trading post here, then I'll get a discount. And I'll need to place two.
It always counts as sort of being down in here as well.
Yes.
All right.
So if I want to build another trading post, the cost is two. So I have to take two of my empty ships, place one here, and return one to the general supply.
Okay.
And now I have discount of two. So if I want to go here, then I only need to place one ship, and then I can get more resources. Than the other.
And so is it you take one action per turn?
You get two actions
per turn. Two actions per turn. So doing this would be an action.
Yes.
And going out and fulfilling these are actions, all right.
Yes. Okay.
Is there another action?
Sure, there's two more to go.
Okay.
Okay, the next thing we want to talk about is increase your investment level.
Right.
Okay? This is very important because when you solve the objective cards, they're only worth 1 point at the start of the game. You have to increase your investment in this kind of good to increase the value.
Right.
Okay, so if you increase it to level two, then each of your yellows will be worth 2 points.
I see.
Up to level three, then it'll be worth 3 points. Okay. Some cards will have a dual colored. That means at the end of the game, you have to choose one color for it to be. So you have
and
some
it goes with that set.
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
There's another limitation. When you're at level two, you only can score two cards. If it's level three, you only can score three cards of that color.
Oh, interesting. Okay.
To pay for that, if you want to go to level two, you have to pay two ships to go to level two. If you want to go to level three, you have to pay three ships. And you cannot jump from level one to level three. Only go one level at a time.
Okay, I understand.
Okay?
Yes, right.
Okay. Also, when you build a trading post, we'll also increase the value of this trading good. And when you push one up, we'll also push one down. Okay? So now, the final action, we'll talk about trading.
Sure.
Trading is very unique in this game. This is the market chart, but this is like an equal value chart. So what that means is, currently, the price of two ships of spice, the red, two ships of red equals three ships of yellow equals four ships
I got
of green.
You. Right.
Equals three ships of blue.
Got it. Okay.
So now I have I have three yellows, so I can trade it for maybe two reds. So I can trade it like this, place it down here, and I place it up here. Now I have two reds. Okay?
All right. Right.
If on another turn, maybe I want to trade two red for four green, but I only have three available ships, so I get three. Okay. So you're also limited by how many ships you have.
I see.
Okay. So that's a very cool part of the worker placement. Okay. At the end of each round, we also do this arms race, okay? So every round, there will be one counter here. This is a resource that the government demanded for the arms race.
Right.
So currently, the guns are in demand. We see which color has more guns. If I have the most guns, then I'll advance one space in the arms race, okay? There's also some different ways to increase your arms level. if I have three training posts in the area, I can increase one level. If I raise this to the level 5, then I also increase my arms level.
And these are victory points at the end of the game, basically?
These shields will be worth victory points at the end of the game. And also, for each opponent you win, you also gain points listed here.
For beating them out. Okay, yes. I see.
Okay. So the game will last for 5 rounds. The play time is about 60 to 90 minutes. The game is good for 1 to 5 players with the expansions.
Oh, there's expansions.
Yes, there's a mini expansion that is probably going to be included with each copy.
Okay, excellent. And is this something that's available right now to
purchase? Yes, you can purchase this from us, and maybe later on, maybe on a geek store, maybe.
Excellent. Well, that's wonderful to hear. Thank you so much for giving us a very quick overview of East Indiaman.
Okay.
Thank you for watching, everyone.
Thank you, bye.